Good morning. Welcome to morning prayer, where we are gathered downtown in Kalamazoo, Michigan, in the heart of our city, and we are crying out to the throne room of God, to the heart of God, asking Him to move in our lives and in our families and in our city. I want to invite you this morning to open up to Psalm chapter 50, wherever you're at. Grab your Bible, grab your journal, as we seek the Lord with great intentionality and expectation this morning. Wherever you are at today, maybe you're joining us online from another state or another area in Michigan, I want to invite you that as we use language for our specific context, like Radiant Church and Kalamazoo and Portage and in our cities, I want to invite you that as we're interceding for our area, that you supplement your region, that you supplement your church, that you stand in the gap for your pastor, that you stand in the gap for your city and your family, that you don't just listen and participate by listening, but you actually take your stance on the wall this morning. You take your position as a watchman on the wall, and that you cry out to God, or maybe God puts another church on your heart to intercede for, or another city, that you would be a watchman this morning, and that you would truly cry out to God for those people, for those families, and for that region. This morning, I want to read the great conclusion of the book of Psalms, Psalm chapter 50, and it ends with the perfect note of everything that all of the psalmists just brought us through. It brings us to this great exclamation point. In Psalm chapter 50, the psalmist says, "Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness." Now note that he doesn't say, "Praise Him according to your circumstance," or "Praise Him according to what is going perfect and good in your life," but "Praise Him according to who He is." Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with lute and harp. Praise Him with tambourine and dance. Praise Him with strings and pipe. Praise Him with sounding cymbals. Praise Him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You may not have a drum set or a harp in front of you. You may not have a tambourine or a horn instrument with you. And some of us, let's be glad that we don't. But you have breath in your lungs, and you have an instrument. And so this morning, with the instrument that God has put inside of your body, with the air that He has given you in this moment, to allow that instrument to make its sound and to let its voice come out, I want us, wherever we're at, whether you're in this room or you're on the live stream, in your car or in an office or at home, wherever you are at, just right now, use that instrument and praise the Lord. Just say, "Lord, I praise You. I praise You, Lord, from where I'm at, with what I'm going through, with what I'm dealing with what I'm struggling in. Lord, I praise You." Just begin to praise Him. It doesn't have to sound beautiful. Just make the sound. Just make the sound of praise. Jesus, we praise You.
Praise the Lord.
reasons.
So many reasons to praise you.
So many reasons, Lord. In our homes.
And I sing praises to your name. Praises to your name. A name that's so much higher than all names. And all
we exalt your name this morning. Great is your name. Great is your name. You have the highest name, Jesus. Name above every other name. And there's power in your name, Jesus. There's power.
Of the morning are inside your eyes. lift up your own song to the Lord. Just tell him how beautiful he is. Tell him how good he is right now.
Singing that, I was hitting this impression in the room or maybe you're on the live stream, and you're singing these words, but you're struggling to put a picture together. Because the things that we qualify as beautiful, we've beheld with our eyes. My mind went to the first time I walked up on the Grand Canyon, and I just gasped as I saw how big and expansive it was, spectacular it was. I had seen pictures, I heard stories, but when I beheld the beauty, it took my breath away. And I just have this impression that we're singing this song and you're like, you're saying, yes, I believe you're beautiful, but I can't identify with actually saying that because I haven't seen it or beheld it myself. And I believe that this morning, as we're singing this song and as we go back into it, I believe that the Lord wants to do a deep, or give a deep revelation to you of himself, a picture of his beauty, of his splendor, one that will take your breath away, not one that's figurative, but one that will grip you for a lifetime. It's like Job said in Job 42, I heard stories about you with my ears. I heard stories about you. People told me about you, and I heard those things with my ears. But now my eyes see you. Now I see you. And the response is not just goosebumps for a moment, but his response from seeing the Lord is, oh, I despise myself and I repent in dust and ashes. His breath is taken away when he sees the splendor and the beauty of God. And so, Lord, I pray right now that all of us, whether in this room or on the live stream, that right now, Lord, that you would show us a glimpse of your beauty, just a fragment, Lord. We've heard stories, we've sung the songs, but Lord, we want to see you. So Lord, I pray that you would open up our eyes right now to see just a glimpse of your beauty. Lord, would you open up our eyes to see your goodness and your beauty right here, right now, in the land of the living, Lord, where we see so much pain and so much trauma and so much hurt and so much ugliness, so much sin, so much decay, so much decomposition in society. Lord, in the midst of this place, in the midst of this time, God, would you show us a glimpse of your beauty? Show us, Lord, your beauty. Show us, Lord, your glory. Show us, Lord. Show us, Lord. Show me your glory. Open up my eyes, Lord, to see
show
you.
Show me your glory.
Show me, Lord.
Show me your glory. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your
pray
beauty.
This.
Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty.
We've heard before,
give
Lord.
Give me a glimpse of
give
your
us a
goodness.
Glimpse. Give us a taste, God.
Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty.
Ruin us today.
Wreck
us today.
Give me a taste of your
with a glimpse, Lord.
Give me a glimpse of your
show
goodness.
Us, Lord.
Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse of your goodness. Give me a taste of your beauty. Give me a glimpse
in the midst of uncertainty.
Give me a taste of your beauty.
In the midst
give
of pain
a glimpse of your goodness.
And anger. disappointment and discouragement. Give us a glimpse, God. Give us a glimpse, God. Of a diagnosis, God. In the midst of physical pain.
We see the edges. We've only heard a whisper. And there's so much more to who we are.
We want more, Lord.
We've only seen the edges. We've only heard a whisper. There is so much more.
Give us more today. That you have called us to be, to live the lives that you've called us to live, to be the city on the hill that cannot be hidden in Kalamazoo and Portage, in Plainwell, in Richland, Otsego, in Battle Creek, Lord. May we be the city on the hill because you have shined upon us and we've seen a glimpse of your glory, God. Lord, give us a glimpse, and when we have the glimpse, would we be like Job? Would we repent? We fall on our faces and repent, Lord, because we've seen, we once heard, but now we've seen Jesus. We heard the stories, but now we've seen, Lord. Take us to that place. And when you take us there, Lord God, May we not settle for anything less, or any substitute, or any fleeting moment, Lord. Show us your glory, Jesus. Show us your glory. Show us your glory. Show us your glory.
Jesus, it's you. Jesus, it's you.
It's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you.
Jesus, it's you.
It's you.
Jesus, it's you.
Preeminent one.
Jesus, it's you.
Powerful one.
Jesus, it's you.
Beautiful one.
Jesus, it's you.
The begotten one. Beautiful. Jesus, it's you. Jesus, it's you. It's you. Tasha just sang us through this in such a powerful way. But Paul, in his words, looking back at his life with his pedigree and his accolades and his stats and his abilities and everything he's done and learned and acquired in his life, he looks at it all and he says, whatever gain I had, I count as a loss for the sake of Christ. Indeed, I count everything a loss because of the surpassing worth. The surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which comes from faith in Christ, the righteousness from God that depends on faith, that I may know him. Jesus, we want to know you. We don't want to just know about you. Lord, just like Job's plea, I've heard stories. Job knew about you. But his eyes were open and he saw you. And when he saw you, everything from that moment changed. Nothing could be the same. He could not return to where he came from. Same with Paul, Lord. And so, Lord, like with Job and like with Paul, Lord, would it be that way with us? Would we see you today in such a way where all we want to do is know you more, and all we want to do is know you greater, and all we want to do is count everything that's behind us as a loss, as rubbish, as trash. Because all we want to do is move forward and know you, not just about you, the power of your resurrection, that we would share in your sufferings, becoming like you unto death, that we, by any means, that it may be possible to attain the resurrection from the dead. Jesus, it is you. Jesus, you are worthy. Jesus, we want to know you more. We've heard about you. We've sung about you. We've seen TikToks about you. We've even heard lies about you. Jesus, we want to see you in a way like Isaiah saw you, in a way like Job saw you, in a way like Paul saw you. Jesus, we want to see you. Jesus, we want to see you and know you more. We want our city to see you and know you. Jesus, we want Southwest Michigan to see you and to know you. We want our families to know you. We want our children to see you and to know you. Jesus, we want our nation to see you and to know you. The Lord, they would come before you the same way that I came before the Grand Canyon that day. In the same way that my eyes were opened up to the expansiveness and the beauty of the Grand Canyon, Lord, would you open up the people's eyes to see how awesome and beautiful and spectacular and holy and awesome you are, that it would take their breath away. And that like Job when he saw you, that they would repent and they would surrender to you. That they would be ruined like the prophet Isaiah said, "Woe to me, I am undone. I am ruined, for my eyes have seen." Lord, would you wreck us today with a glimpse of your beauty, with a glimpse of your splendor. Jesus, it's you.
Jesus, it's you.
Over Battle Creek, Plainwell, Otsego, Southwest Michigan, we prophesy these simple words. Simple yet profound. Simple yet powerful. Jesus, it's you. It's you. We prophesy, Jesus, it's you. Over our church and over our families, over our marriages, over our children. Jesus, it's you. Jesus, you are beautiful. May that lyric, may that song be resonating all day long within our spirits. Jesus, you're beautiful. Jesus, it's you. Jesus, you're beautiful. Jesus, it's you. May we not just leave this moment and this hour forgetting how beautiful you are and spectacular you are, but may it just keep growing in us all day long. Jesus, we thank you for this day that you have made. choose to go into it rejoicing with gladness. Amen. Amen. Thank you for joining us in the prayer room today. We'll be back at noon. Thank you for joining us online. We'll be back in the morning. We want to invite you down to the prayer meeting. We are down here every morning and every time, every day at noon and at 6:30. Have a blessed day. Mm-hmm.